see about the chain of responsibility design pattern, theoretical real life examples, and then principles. In the next video, we'll try to cover the practical implementation of chain of responsibility design pattern. So this comes under this chain of responsibility design pattern comes under behavioral design pattern. There are three categories of design patterns. One is the creational, structural, and then behavioral. This comes under behavioral design pattern. Here the main motto behind the chain of responsibility design pattern is avoid coupling the sender of a request to its receiver by giving more than one receiver object a chance to handle the request. So here there are, if suppose we assume this is a client and these are the some servers, instead of assigning the jobs to a particular server, if we don't assign to a particular server, that request would be solved by any servers at runtime. So for example, if suppose if you are using Amazon website, if you are trying to log into the Amazon website using username and password, and then our request would be served by any one of those Amazon servers. So we are, the client won't aware about the server details, etc. The client fire some request, that request would be solved by any of those servers, and then chain the receiving object and pause the request along the chain until an object handles it. For example, we'll take the previous example itself. If suppose if you are logging to the Amazon website, we are trying to give the username password. If suppose this receiver one will handles only the permission related information. For example, this receiver knows only to check whether that user name and password are valid and etc. Valid only. And after doing that operation, this receiver one will acknowledge receiver two that I have validated this credentials, then you can take the further jobs like that. And the receiver two does some job and then it hand over the remaining job to receiver three. So chain the receiving objects and pause the request along the chain until an object is handles it. It creates a chain of receiver objects for a request. We have already discussed about this point in the previous example. Each receiver contains reference to another receiver. If one receiver cannot handle the request, then it will pass to the next service. We have already covered about this point in the previous explanation. If suppose if a client is sending some request to the server, if one receiver doesn't know how to handle that request, that would be forwarded to the other receiver by using the reference. This receiver one will have the reference of receiver two. This receiver two will have the reference of receiver three. And then these are the two categories by which a chain of responsibility design pattern can be implemented. First category is one receiver handles the request in the chain. Second category is one or more receivers in the chain handles the request. We can explain about these categories using real life examples. So this is the one receiver example and this is the second example to explain about one or more receivers acting at the same time. For example, we will consider a quiz competition. Lenny is the quiz competitor. Lenny is conducting the quiz competition and Raja, Chenchu and Sudha are the quiz competitors. They are trying to attend the quiz competition. So first Lenny is asking the question to Raja. If suppose Raja doesn't know the answer for that question, Raja will transfer that question to Chenchu. Chenchu will try to answer that question. If suppose if Chenchu doesn't know the answer about that question, then he will forward that question to Sudha. Here the request has been forwarded to other receivers. If the receiver has no idea to reply to that request. So this is the example where one receiver handles a request in the chain. Another example is one or more receivers handles a request at the same time. For example, if suppose Lenin is visiting an ATM machine and he is trying to withdraw 520 rupees. If he is entering 520 rupees, that 520 rupees would be handled by three receivers at the same time. 100 rupees receiver, 50 rupees receiver, 20 rupees receiver. So what the 100 rupees receiver will do is it will try to pick the best number of under rupees notes, and then 50 rupees receivers will try to pick the number of 50 notes, 20 rupees receiver will try to pick the number of 20 rupees notes. So for 520 rupees, the 100 rupees receiver would return 4 into 100, which means 400 rupees, 50 rupees receiver would serve 2 into 50, which means 100, 20 rupees receiver would serve 1 into 20, 20 rupees. Here, 3 receivers are acting at the same time. So, 3 receivers are communicating with them, communicating among them to reply the client with the best response. So, that's the second case where one or more receivers are handling a request in a chain. So, this is the example about the chain of responsibility design pattern in real life example. If suppose if you have any other doubts, you could comment those things in the comment section. I will try to answer those whenever I see it.